Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the Roswell Women's Club, welcome to the 2013 Meet the Candidates Forum. I'm Cheryl Rappaport. I'm co-chair of the Public Affairs Committee, and I would really like to thank everyone for coming out tonight for this event. And also, I'd just like to take one moment to recognize our president this year, Ms. Julian Tomesh. Would you stand, please? Thank you. Thank you so much. And now, could we please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic.
Now, this time, I would like to introduce the mayor of Roswell and ask him to say a few words. So please welcome Mayor Jere.
Thank you. It's great to be back at a women's club debate. I was recollecting, we were asking how long the women's club has been doing this. No one here has been around long enough to remember. I just know the first time I debated in front of the women's club, I was 29. Just a few short years ago. I want to thank everyone for coming tonight and caring enough about the city of Roswell to show up. And I want to thank all of the candidates for not running against me. That was great. But this is an important election. This will decide Roswell's future. The council, not the mayor, sets your tax rates, decides where to spend the money, and decides how to zone your property, and makes all those other decisions. I get to cut the ribbons, but the council is the one who really makes the decision, so this is an important decision. Now, I want to take a little bit of this time to talk about Unified Development Code. I know it's an issue in this race. I know a lot of people, there's a lot of attention on it. It's called the UDC for short, so I'm going to be talking about the UDC here, and I hope you'll bear with me just for a minute. First, I want to say that everyone recognizes that Roswell's zoning code needs to be simplified and made clearer. But there are a lot of folks who are not supporting the Unified Development Code because they have some fears about it, and I want to address those fears. The three fears I think that people have for the Unified Development Code is that it allows increased density, that it allows for more apartments, and it will change the zoning approval process. And I believe that the critics who have those fears, I understand where they are because there have been a lot of changes in the Unified Development Code, but I think we're at the point of those fears are based upon information and not really something to really fear. There have been a lot of changes. First, I want to talk about the fear of increased density. There was a citizens committee that worked on this zoning code for 2 years before it came for a review by a council. And they had looked at increasing the density and putting commercial development at the 400 Oakland Bridge Road interchange, which would have increased significant change in density. When this came to the council said this takes further review and decided not to make that change. So the biggest fear of increased density there at the Oakland Bridge 400 interchange is not taking place. The council said we're going to leave it zoned for apartments and save that for further discussion. It's currently developed as apartments in two cars. They're not changing that zoning, they're not changing any of the zoning, so there'll be no increase in density at that intersection. And that is something that was a recent vote, so I'm sure a lot of the critics were not aware of that vote. The next fear was the fear of more apartments. What they don't understand is how this Unified Development Code works. There are no apartments, there's no property zoned for apartments on the Unified Development Code that is not currently zoned for apartments. There is a conditional zoning process that if a developer wishes to develop for apartments, he can file an application with the city, he can appear before the neighborhoods, he can go in front of the Planning Commission, have a public hearing, go in front of the council, have a public hearing, and then if he gets a majority of the votes, and only then would more apartments be allowed. And that is the same process as rezoning. So this Unified Development Code is not approving any more apartments or not. It's simply saying, in some of our old strip centers where we want to see mixed-use development, we want to give that as an option to bring apartments into the mixed-use development and to redevelop some of these old shopping centers. And the last fear was really of the zoning approval process. People are saying, we're going to be taking away from the public hearings and the right to be heard. That is not true. Again, I simply think they don't understand Unified Development Code. The zoning approval process is not going to change. Again, you're going to have to file for a permit. You're going to have to go before a neighborhood meeting to discuss it. You're going to have to go before the planning committee to discuss it. You're going to have a public hearing before the council, and you're still going to have a majority vote before there's any rezoning, any change in the gazational zoning. So as far as the process, it is the same process we have right now. Now, I will tell you what the biggest change in Unified Development Code is. And that is, under our current zoning, we really don't tell people what we want. There are a lot of rules, but it's not really illustrated what we want. Under this Unified Development Code, we're making an effort to tell the community, this is what we'd like to see, with illustrations and examples, so that we hope by telling people what we want, we have a much better chance of getting it than if we just tell them what we don't want. And that's really the change in Unified Development Code. So I encourage all the folks, the candidates, and all of y'all who are concerned about it to review it, but that's my review of it, as best I can tell. And with that, I'll sit down, but I want to encourage you to talk to your friends and neighbors. You are the most influential group in Roswell right now, because you're going to, when you leave this meeting, you're going to be more knowledgeable than any of your friends and any of your neighbors. So I want you to tell them what you heard. And also, we want this video played so that more citizens will get an opportunity to hear from our council. It has been a pleasure to serve you for 16 years. And with no opposition, I hope it will be my pleasure to serve for you.
Thank you, Mayor. And now, it is my great pleasure to introduce the moderator for this forum. He's the executive editor of Appen Media. And please join me in welcoming now Mr. Hatcher Hurd.
Thank you, Mayor, for clarifying the UEC. It's one less question I have. Just so you understand, we're going to have our candidates here. I'm about to introduce them. And the host four will begin the parade. The others will be off stage until their time is here. And we will have a 2-minute introduction that they will give. We will have 3 rounds of questions that they will each answer. And they'll each have a 1-minute summation. Now, first of all, host four with the incumbent Jere Wood and Mr. Jere Orlans.
That's our new team, sir.
I messed it up already. Okay. All right. Host four. All right. They have here as Jere Orlans. I'm sorry. Kent Igleheart and Harvey Smith. Kent is lived in the Roswell City since 1994 and has served on the council for 12 years. He has been a small business owner and has been a very ardent green supporter of keeping this city green. He now makes acting his primary focus of work and has appeared in more than 60 films, TV shows, commercials, and even corporate training videos. Most recently, you might have seen him in Swamp Murders, called The Last Punch. So, please stand. I got this right. Mr. Harvey is Harvey Smith. I'm not Harvey. Is an Atlanta native. He's a Georgia State licensed contractor and certified professional home builder. He's had a career in home building, building over 250 homes in the Roswell area, and has been a realtor with Keller Williams Realty. He's an active member of the Rotary and has recently served as president, like those presidents before him and after him, was president during the Club of the Year in Georgia. So that's something that is a string that's been unbroken, and he helps continue that string. Please. According to my notes, then post five is Jere Orlans. Okay, Mr. Orlans is in his fifth term as the city councilman. He serves 9 years now on the board of directors of North Fulton Hospital. He is a longtime member of the Roswell Rotary Club, and it's set on the boards of the North Fulton Community Foundation and the North Fulton YMCA. He's a businessman and longtime supporter of many, many charities here in the town. Eric Schumacher, relocated to Georgia in 2009. He has an office in Alpharetta, but he chooses to live in Roswell because he likes the historic small town charm and character of the city. And Roswell is where he met and married his wife, and now they're starting a family. He was educated in fine art, computer science, and business administration and marketing. Is there anything you can't do? He's running for city council because of his commitment to public service and to the city of Roswell. Post 6, Nancy Diamond is a truly 9-year resident of Roswell. She moved here when she was first born. She and her husband Glenn have raised 2 daughters, both of them graduated from Roswell High and have since graduated college. Congratulations there. She first worked for CNN and then was a freelancer in sports and television graphics until she began to raise her family. She made community service part of her life here in Roswell, and she's volunteered for many committees, especially with the Star House Foundation, North Fulton Hospital Board, and the Roswell Arts Festival Committee. Her opponent, Kendra Myers Cox, grew up in Roswell. She was thrilled to be able to settle here and to raise her family. She has a bachelor's degree in English and Drama from Duke University, and a master's degree in Southern Studies from the University of Mississippi. Where else would you get a master's degree in Southern Studies? She's a published author, a produced playwright, and she's an alumna of Dad's Garage Theater Company. And she says she looks forward to carrying out a vision for Roswell that honors our past and preserves our quality of life. Kendra. At this time, we're going to allow Harvey and Kent to assume the podium for the first round, and the other candidates will wait outside. Now, a coin flip is determined who will be introduced first, and then who will speak last. You have 2 minutes when you're ready.
Sponsoring these forums election after election, and thanks to everyone for being here tonight. I fully support change and growth and redevelopment, but we have to make sure it's done right, or we're all going to pay the price. Now, I've spent 15 years dealing with zoning in one form or another. That's why I'm such a stickler for maintaining high standards, because all too often I've seen things done wrong, and under the impact impact that they can have on both our city and our quality of life. We need to make our complete focus on changing our blighted areas into places that match Roswell's character. We need to do that with a phased, conservative approach. Let's start with the key areas that we all agree need to be fixed and learn what works best. We need to be very careful in what we allow. If we simply open the door to higher densities, then I do disagree with the mayor's description of what can happen in development in too many places, then we actually will lessen the likelihood of redevelopment of our problem areas. And we all know where these problem areas are. They are empty strip malls, or used car lots, or run-down apartments. We need to turn these specific locations into thriving areas like mixed-use villages that have reasonable heights and densities. We can recreate Camp Street for other areas. You might have noticed that Camp Street has one or two-story buildings, some buildings on the street, some not, a lot of green space. If we want to recreate that feel, we need to place zoning limits closer to that feel. Let's transform our rundown apartments. But if we simply rebuild them substantially higher densities, we're only creating even a worse problem 15, 20 years down the road, and creating short-term problems for our schools, our traffic, and our quality of life. And the devil's always in the details. Frankly, we aren't paying enough attention to those details. We need someone to ask the difficult questions and continually push the process to justify what we're doing. That's what I do. You may not always agree with me, but I hope that we can all see the value of challenging what we're doing in order to make the end result the best it can be. So I ask for your support to continue playing an important role for our city's future. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Smith.
Thank you, Hatcher. Good evening, everyone. My name is Harvey Smith. I'll introduce myself again, but I'd like to thank the Roswell Women's Club for putting this on, and for Hatcher being the moderator tonight. I'd like to thank you, the citizens of Roswell, for coming out, taking the time to come out tonight and have your questions about this important election heard. Just a little bit more about me. I'm a native Atlantan. Lived here in Roswell for over 26 years. I'm married. My wife Donna is here in the audience, and I have three grown children, Doug, Holly, and Heather. I think Holly's here tonight also with us. I'm a small business owner. I've been involved in construction, real estate. We build offices and homes throughout the city. I've been very involved in the community. Been involved with Roswell Rotary for over 22 years, served as past president. Child Development Association, Star House, Roswell Historical Society, and it's been an honor and privilege to serve for the past 3 years on the Roswell Planning Commission. What compelled me to run for this position? I believe in community service, and I want to pay back what this community has given to me and my family. I also want to preserve the history, quality of life, and joy in Roswell through promoting quality businesses, promoting innovative ways to solve traffic problems, protecting home values. And, you know, one way of accomplishing those three things will be through the passage of the UDC. I beg to differ with my opponent, but, you know, the devil isn't in the details. We've had several public hearings. We're continuing to have public hearings. We want your voices to be heard. I thank you for the opportunity to serve you.
Thank you. Ms. Igleheart, your first question. How do you promote redevelopment in Roswell?
Well, as I have said a number of times throughout the campaign, I think we need to focus the redevelopment on specific places. We already know that we've got our strip shopping centers that are widely open, not too many shops in there. Our areas on Highway 9 here with used car lots and many of our run-out apartments. We need to focus our redevelopment on those spots. I do accept that we can go some higher densities in those areas. We can mix uses, but going beyond a three or four story limit and having unlimited density as some of our parts of the UDC will do, I think will harm our long-term efforts. So I think if we focus on bringing good developers, we need to go recruit them to work on some of these specific areas. Like I said, we can recreate the kind of things that we see that we like in our city on these places. You know, a lot of people from other areas of the city can't go to Camp Street because it's so hard to park sometimes. But if we create Camp Street over there on some of the strip shopping centers on the east side and some other areas that have those, they can have their own Camp Street. Where the apartments are right now, what we call Northwest Quadrant, Big Creek runs right through there. It's a beautiful water area that we don't even use. It's just the backside of some apartments. If we flip that whole space over around to that water, we can build restaurants that have waterfronts. We can build high-end homes and townhomes that are right there on the water and have additional apartments as well. But as I said, if we put high-density apartments back in there, I think we're causing a lot of problems. But that redevelopment would be in those specific places. And that's my focus, and what I keep saying is, if we allow a lot of other areas to be where development can happen, then we're not going to see those tougher places to redevelop be done, certainly not in the short term. Let's try those first. Let's see what works. Let's focus on those. And as that begins to be successful, then we can move on to other places and see how that works as well.
Thank you. Mr. Harvey, do you favor the move by the city to have an appointed judge rather than an elected judge and to outsource court services?
Two-part question. You know, the first part, I know that's been a very controversial topic. I think the current council, I think they have, they're getting advice on that through an outside consultant. I mean, that's something that really, I think the information is forthcoming. I mean, I'd like to make my decision or offer an opinion on that when we all have the same information to you know, make a judgment on that or whether or not it should have an elected or an appointed judge. As far as whether or not court services should be outsourced or privatized, again, that's going to be, you'll look at the impact that would have. You know, being a small business owner, I look for efficiencies, I look for how we can save money, and what is the most efficient way to operate our city, because that'll be one of my goals. I'll treat it like a small business. You know, I would, it's going to depend on those circumstances when we reach that and the proposal that's given to us at that time. As far as whether or not I would say yes, we should do that, or no, we should not.
Thank you. Kent, Georgia Florida Corridor, Hope Bridge Road, seems to be a crime center for us. What can we do to fight crime, especially in that area?
Well, oddly enough, the location of that crime also happens to be where some of our rundown apartments are. That is a pretty close correlation, and that's true not only in that one little section, but others as well. In the short term, we've done a number of things through our police department with working with the management companies. We've had code enforcement type things that have gone through the apartments to make sure that they are meeting our basic codes, because a lot of times we had all kinds of stuff going on in the apartments, the little restaurants and other legal activities that we've worked hard to push out. We've worked with putting police officers who now live in many of those apartments to try and have that in the car they bring home that's in the parking lot. Our police departments have become very community friendly in working with those areas so that people know them in there. We've done what we can to deal with those issues now. Longer term, again, I think we all agree that we need to redevelop those apartments. If we leave it like that, it's only going to get worse. But again, my contention is if we put in double the density, which we've just done right behind here on Fraser Street, all you're doing is creating a major problem for the future. Because frankly, the more people you stick together that are all close together, the more issues people tend to have. So you know, that's our longer term approach. That again, what I just said on some others, I don't mean to repeat myself, but I don't have the same idea for the same things. That we make those into mixed use villages, there's a mix of apartments, there's some other incomes in there, there's other types of uses, so that we separate that out. And we had big high-rise, essentially apartments downtown, Atlanta Housing Authority ran those. They tore them all down. And they did this. They created mixed-use villages. It's been very successful. And then other cities around the country, Chicago and others. So we need to learn from those who've done that kind of thing and had success and implement the same things here.
Thanks. Harvey, you're a businessman. What are your ideas to promote redevelopment in the city?
Well, first of all, I would recommend creating a template like UDC. I would like to see the passage of the UDC in a form that the city is in agreement with. That is a template that will allow developers, other business people, to come to Roswell and see what we have to offer. It won't waste money on unnecessary due diligence looking at a piece of property. It won't spin their wheels. I've been involved in real estate my entire life. The last thing you want to do is waste money with professional fees to determine whether or not a property can be developed or if it will be conducive or there will be resistance from areas. So the other aspect, I think, promoting a public-private partnership like we have with the Roswell Business Associates, which is now Roswell Inc., that is a liaison between the city and the business community to help foster an atmosphere to bring developers in, other people in to redevelop. We need to think about transportation issues that would that are impeding the growth. I mean, Camp Street, we've got to think outside the box. I'm a proponent of the TED Talks. I believe that that is something that's been very popular, been very well received in the Northeast. I know our transportation department is familiar with that, but have pedestrian plazas, maybe cordoning off certain areas during certain events, other than live after five, doing things that don't require extra studies, but can be implemented very quickly and easily and inexpensively. We don't need to create new infrastructure to promote redevelopment. We just need to work with what we've got and have fresh new ideas to push that ball along. We're doing a lot of things right now. We want to continue to do that.
All right, Kat, 12 years on the council. What does Roswell do best and what does it do worst?
I think best we foster the kind of place that we all love to call home. I mean, obviously, we are here for a reason. It's a great place with great parks. We've invested in those. We continually put more money into those to maintain. I think we need to put more money into those to maintain even more, but we continually build new programs through that. We work on our transportation problems. We've got numerous issues that are longer term, that we're never going to totally solve traffic problems. But there are things on the works that we've got going, the things we've done, the roundabout, just right over here, that has been put in and had been a huge success. I think we do listen to neighbors and our residents throughout the city, as well as small businesses. We've worked hard to make it a place that you can live, work, and play.
There's well, a lot more. What do you need to do better?
I got my second minute here. The good is a whole lot longer. The bad, I think, it's the issues that any city that's been around for a long time faces. We do have blighted areas. We do have areas that have higher crime, we mentioned. We're at that stage now where we don't have any new basic rural land. Our city limits are set. So how do we transform what we have? And I think that's still a discussion that we need to have. I think some of this, the UDC discussion, and any of my colleagues will disagree with me, but we haven't had as much of an open debate on that, I think. We need to do that more. We're actually listening to what everybody's saying and not just having a public meeting where we're talking about an issue to people. I think things are pretty good here. That's why I've been here even longer, I've been on council, and why I wanted to continue to work on trying to enhance what we've got.
Thanks. Harvey, you're a first-time candidate. What made you want to take a seat on the city council, and what do you want to do most?
As I said in my opening remarks, I've been here over 26 years. This community has been a great place to live for me and my family. Raised three kids. It is really, I know it sounds corny, but it's I believe in community service. I believe it's a civic duty to pay back to the community that you live in, you live in, you love it. I want to preserve the quality of life we have here. And I want to preserve the quality of life through, primarily three areas: promoting businesses, promoting ideas that will alleviate the traffic problems that we have. I had indicated earlier that I know Camp Street has been just a phenomenal redevelopment opportunity that we're all, we're the darling of many cities. It's amazing that we have people from Buckhead, Sandy Springs coming up to us now instead of the other way around. The last thing would be I want to protect the values of your homes. The thought process, that's where we have, for most people, home ownership is the number one, is the largest investment, the number one asset they have, and when that value increases, it's a trickle-down effect throughout the economy. We have more disposable income. It's just a positive that, all the obvious reasons why that is important. We don't want declining values. So I'm going to be a proponent of any, I'm going to stand behind or oppose any thing that would possibly decrease the property values of your home. And that's what gives us the quality of life we enjoy.
Thank you. You each get a 1 minute summation. Mr. Hart.
Thank you. Again, thank you for taking the time to come out tonight, and I know a lot of you have better things to do, but your participation is what makes this city special, what makes it one of the most desirable places to live. Our city is moving in the right direction, contrary to what some people would say. I mean, the sky is not falling. We've been through a rough economic segment, and our economy is growing. Businesses are moving to Roswell with new jobs. I mean, Roswell is a destination again. It's a place to live. It's thriving. But I applaud our accomplishments, but there's still work to be done. Good things can be better. Bad things can change. But the question you may have is, why would you vote for me? And what I would say to you is, vote for me if you want a councilman who is involved in the community, is a strong leader, is a problem solver, has the courage to make the right decisions, has business experience, will be accessible to you. My cell phone won't be cut off at nighttime. I will attend city functions, and I will promote business. So, thank you.
Thank you. Everyone agrees we need to change and we need to redevelop, but how much and how fast? And we all love living here. We all love what we have here. It's a great place to call home. But that came from a conservative, balanced approach in what we allowed to be built. We've made some mistakes along the way. Let's fix those and be careful that we don't create new ones, at least lessen the new ones we may have made. If you look at things said tonight, the things my opponent and I have done and said on the record regarding zoning, there's a clear choice here. If you look at the knowledge base and experience from a neighborhood perspective, there's a clear choice here. And frankly, the developer viewpoint has been well represented in our process. Do we need more of that, or do we need to make sure our neighborhood voices are truly heard? I ask for your vote to continue being the one to ask the tough questions, to fight to protect and enhance Roswell's character, and to make what we're doing the best that it can be. Again, thank you for being here. I agree there's so many more things that you could be doing tonight, and thank you for being invested in our community's future.
Thank you for your time, Joe. Our next candidate can come forward.
Meetings to learn what was going on in our city. I knew that Roswell was a great place to live. I wanted to make it a more vibrant and healthy city, a place where Brenda and I could raise our children. Then in 1997, I started my own business. And of course, I located in Roswell. Where else would I locate? Located right behind Sloth's Barbecue on my Crossville Highway. Working and living in the community have offered me the ability to stay close to the residents in order to hear their issues, their desires, such as protecting our natural resources, protecting our quality of life, and in a small town community atmosphere, a place where people gather with family and friends, like on Cannon Street area, which has become much more vibrant yet has retained its charm. With excellent schools, tremendous quality of life, and the right kind of growth, everything seems to be headed in the right direction. Roswell has maintained its AAA bond rating based on our financial management and stability. These are exciting times for Roswell. Having experience of being on the city council, being in business, being involved in the community, all help to make me the best candidate for your election. When I say involved in the community, you heard some of them before, being on a board of directors of several different communities and involved in nonprofits. Roswell's won many awards over the years, and I've tried to provide the type of leadership the city needed to win these awards and have these accomplishments. And I pledge to continue that type of leadership going forward. Thank you.
Great, thank you. Again, my name is Eric Schumacher. I'm running for post 5. Thank you for this opportunity. I'm not sure what questions are going to be asked or if I'm going to have the time to answer them all. To give you a clear understanding of how I can represent you on City Council, I would like everybody to leave tonight with the impression that I'm qualified for this position, that I'll bring new energy and new ideas to City Council, that I want to preserve the charm and character of Roswell, the charm and character of our neighborhoods and everything in between our neighborhoods. I value our local businesses and believe we should protect and support them when we explore future developments. I fully support improving and perfecting our zoning ordinances, but we need to take the time to get them right. I will work to ensure we return to true representation of the citizens of Roswell. I believe City Council should be more engaged than they are today. I'll be more involved than my opponent. I believe we can do more with what we have today. I want the city to measure its efforts and multiply and reward our successes. We need to be more transparent. If your questions don't get asked and answered tonight, or if you'd like to hear more on a certain topic, please visit my website, ericforroswell.com. Thank you.
Here's a question for Mr. Schumacher. What do you feel is the single most important duty of any city council member?
That's clearly to represent the people of the city we live in and to ensure that the city has a short-term and long-term strategy for growth, as well as preserving and supporting the families that we have in the city. When I go around to people canvassing for this campaign, quite a few people are telling me that they feel that the current city council is isolating themselves, and that they don't feel that they're truly supported by the city council. That has been actually my case as well. My thought when I was thinking about running for council this year, I went to a lot of meetings, UDC meetings in particular. And during those meetings, you know, they were supposed to be community outreach meetings where people can ask questions. But when I asked questions at those meetings, I was asked to be quiet and go into the other room and have one-on-one sessions. I don't really feel that the city is currently open to debate on topics that are most important to us. So I truly believe that we need to return to to true representation and feedback from our citizens and really listen to what the people that made the city want. You know, with the UDC, we're changing a lot of things, and I think a lot of change is good. But a lot of the people that live here moved here because we want a small town feel. So I think we need to respect that. Thank you.
Thank you. Ms. Orlans, the Grove Blade overlay aims to duplicate a lot of the success of Canton Street. Where do you rank that in priorities for the city?
Well, excuse me. If you look at the two areas of the city that have done really well and been somewhat successful, if you want to classify it that way, has been the Canton Street area and the Parkway Village area. Both of those are mixed-use areas. In the historic district, you know, we allow housing residential there. We allow houses to be used as offices. There's restaurants. It's a total mixed-use area. Parkway Village allowed different types of use as well. They weren't quite as mixed there as they are in the historic district. So I think if you look at that, those are two good areas of the city that have been successful using some type of mixed use, not segregating all of our different zoning issues. The Groveway zoning was set up to be exactly that. It was set up to be a mixed use area where you can have residential, commercial, businesses, offices. You can have it all together. And it's an area that needs some redevelopment. So it is a way to help redevelop the area. So I think it's a very good thing for Roswell, and I think it's gonna change, who knows on a timing, but 3, 4, 5 years from now, you'll see kind of a Canton Street area that I think is expanded. And filling in on that side of Highway 9 and even moving into over around behind maybe City Hall. So basically, I think it's a good direction to go in for this area.
Eric, the city is considering a appointed municipal court judge rather than elected. Do you support that, or do you support the outsourcing of court services?
I support public-private partnerships, for sure. There are definitely opportunities there to be more efficient. We can get the same quality of services we have for a lot of our departments by outsourcing those. And if we run into problems with those outsourced services, we can certainly look to renew those with new contracts. I support an elected judge for our courts. I believe we're the last city in Georgia to actually have an elected judge. We should be proud of that. It's important for us to have separation in our government as much as we can at the municipal level. I know that there are a lot of strong arguments for an appointed judge. For instance, there's concern that you know, a judge should run a campaign, but I believe if we have some candidates in mind for appointing a judge in our city, that they could actually run for that position. So out of respect for what made this country great, I believe that we should have an elected judge.
Thank you. We're about to spend a lot of money, Jere, to modernize our water system that serves about a fourth of our citizens. Does Roswell really need to be in the water business?
Well, it, you know, there's so many different aspects to this. One, how much you want to depend on Fulton County for the future. We've tried to depend on them for things in the past, and that hasn't always worked out. We have a tremendous crew in our water plant. They've won awards all over the state and nationally. They do a tremendous job. The water plant, by having it here, also gives us some advantages on our drainage system, the going up creek, Big Creek, and it gives us some advantages on how we're doing there and what development can be done further upstream. So there's a lot of little different things that come into play for the water plant. You know, if we get a Milton County
and we try to start developing our own water system. You know, I think Roswell's crew and Roswell's situation could be in position to help do that. So it's I think we've raised the bills on the water, the price on the water bill went up $1 per month to cover the capital cost, and that will reduce the maintenance and the cost of it long term, so that hopefully the cost will come back down there.
Eric, what will you do to promote redevelopment in the city?
Well, that's an excellent question. I think we need to spend some time on the UDC and get it right, as I mentioned earlier. There are a lot of good things about the UDC. There are a lot of good things in our existing zoning ordinances. But we do really need to spend the time to first get the rules right, perhaps take a phased approach, get the rules right, and then look at remapping properties in the city. Our strategic economic plan and our comprehensive plan both talk about doing that in a strategic way, looking at certain properties to redevelop. For instance, if we have a blighted shopping center today, I believe that under the UDC and using the UDC as a tool for our city, we should spend the time targeting just those properties instead of blanketing a good portion of Roswell with new zoning ordinances and new zoning for our parcels and just hope for the best. We don't want to start a new phase of light for our existing businesses. We should support our existing businesses that are currently successful in some of these areas. If we rezone a good portion of our city without targeting specific things, what's to keep a developer from developing next door to something that's blighted? We should really very carefully allow our current property owners to pick what they want under the UDC rules to be incentivized to actually make some changes. We should also attract businesses to this area that really enhance what we have here today. So we need to preserve the charm and character. So I believe that in our corridor, our Hook and Ridge 400 area, I'd like to see a university or something that's going to attract the younger segment, promote walkability, and perhaps position us for some additional transportation. Thank you.
Perfect. Mr. Horowitz, Georgia 400 physically divides the city into east and west. There's also a perception of division in the city of the east side versus the west side and competition for resources. What can you do to make sure this is perceived as West City?
Well, I think I've tried to do that over the years. I don't really consider a divided city. I consider it one city. We represent everyone. That's why we run the election citywide. We've had discussions in the past about setting up districts, and that's one of the reasons I don't think we should have districts. That creates division. So I think running citywide and being interested in the entire city is the key and the way to go. You know, I remember sitting with the board of directors Sentinel on the River, I'm not sure, three years ago perhaps, maybe two to 3 years ago, talking about the trail system coming up East Road. We're finally there now, and we're finally putting that in. We put trail systems along Holcomb Bridge Road. So we are doing things on that side of town. The majority of our park area is on the east side of town. So we try to do things on both sides. Now, we have geographical differences, just like, you know, the historic district is a geographical area. And so there we're talking about tourism, commercialism, or for tourism to bring money in that way. So each segment of the city, geographically, may have different needs and different things we can do. But as I said, you know, the majority of percentage of our parkland is on the east side of town, putting new trails in there. I think we're doing a good job of trying to treat the entire city as one.
Thank you. Now we have time for our submissions. Mr. Schumacher, it's your turn.
Great. Well, I guess in summation, it's really important right now that we spend the time and effort needed to get UDC right. This changes things forever. You need somebody on city council that is willing to get involved, to ensure we ask the tough questions, to make sure we understand how some of our zoning ordinances can be abused before we actually implement them. We need to change a lot of the things that I've seen today to ensure that we don't make any mistakes. The mistakes we make with UDC are permanent. We're giving out zoning rights with these changes, and we can't repeal them. Further, with some of our zoning changes under the UDC, people who have existing properties won't be able to do what they can today under the UDC. I know that sounds strange, but it's true. Today, we need to make a change on city council to ensure we're protected. Thank you.
I don't know if that's coming from existing properties, can't do what they want to do now, but the UDC has been a long process. We've been working on it for 18 months. We have not even gotten to the public hearing process. That starts over the next 3 to 4 months. All of this so far has been educational, getting input from property owners, getting input from people. So people making the assumption that the UDC is there, and these are all negative things from it, they're changing. We are looking at it. We are taking citizen input. Those initial meetings were informational meetings. We have not had any public hearings yet. They start this month and will go until February. So we will get a lot of citizen input. In the last few years, during the recession, we worked hard to position our city for the future. We established the DDA, Downtown Development Authority, the Roswell Business Alliance, to help rejuvenate our city. These are public-private partnerships. The RBA in the last year and a half has brought in 2,000 plus new jobs into empty buildings. Anyway, I think these are all things that are going in the right direction, all positive, exciting times for Roswell. Thank you for allowing me to serve this great city over the years. I don't take your trust lightly, and I do my best to represent you with integrity, balance, and consistency. Please vote for me on November 5th. Thank you.
Thank you, Ruth.
Conversation with 90,000 people takes time and it can be messy, but it's important. All those things will help us keep our goals in reach. It's important to me that families continue to choose to raise their children here, that our children have the option to make their adult lives here, and that our seniors, which is now me, have the option to stay here. It's not a perfect world, and we have some challenges and differences and hard decisions to make. I have a 29-year track record of listening and bringing people together to do positive things. I ask for your vote so that we may continue to build a bright future for our city.
Thanks. Kendra?
Thank you, Hatcher, and thank you all for coming tonight for taking part in this important decision for your city council for Roswell's future. I am here because I am one of those who was born and raised born in Atlanta and raised in Roswell. Very fortunate to be back here now with my husband and daughter and where my parents still are. And I decided when we moved back that I wanted our move back to be more than a lucky coincidence, more than I get to come home where I know all the shortcuts and I have free babysitting. Sorry, Mom and Dad. I wanted to have more involvement in this city that was such a big part of shaping who I am. I also decided to run for city council after becoming involved in some local issues and getting to know some of my neighbors. Roswell's a lot bigger than it was when I graduated from Roswell High in 91. And I sensed some fatigue among our fellow residents, a sense of not feeling welcome in our city government, where they felt like a nuisance instead of a real participant in the process. And I thought, that's something that I can change. I have a long history as a scientific writer-editor in health, in the public and private sector, and so I know what real community engagement is. It's a dialogue, it's a two-way street, and it's a process that we can rely on so that we know that when the public is providing input, it's going somewhere and it's meaningful. It's not just for show. I also decided to run for city council because I am concerned about certain aspects of the UDC, the Unified Development Code. Particularly, I think there's not enough focus on infrastructure. I'm very excited about the idea of redeveloping some of our rundown areas, but I think if we rush headlong into developing and redeveloping without really considering our quality of life, which includes traffic and schools, then we might run into trouble. So I ask for your vote, and I'm looking forward to sharing some more of my ideas. Thank you.
Thank you. The roadway overlay has been hailed as a chance to replicate the success of Ken Street down towards the river, south of the courthouse. What is your opinion of this, and how do you prioritize its construction? Yes, Nancy, I'm sorry.
I think the roadway overlay has been successful so far in that, if nothing else, there was a certain big box that was headed for us that is no longer headed for us because the requirements were very strict. It is giving us a chance to impose some design guidelines and some restrictions on how that area develops that gives us a better chance at high quality development. I think there's a number of things in process that are already making that connection. Our goal is to make that connection between the square, the river, the square, and Canton Street. And I think to the degree the Midtown overlay has done some of that on the north side, we're starting to see activity on the south side, and I think it's really headed in a good direction. There will be dirt moving in the next few months, and I think you'll see a lot more of that, but I think it's not been the fear that a lot of people had going in, much like with the UDC, that there would be this headlong rush of huge development, and that really isn't the way it's set up. It's got to meet the transportation, the stormwater, the parking, all those criteria for it to be developed, and it's not going to be any different than any of the processes we've had before for that to happen. So I feel like it's going in a good direction, and there's some great projects on the map, and we're going to see more of it very soon.
Kendra, the city is moving towards the appointment of a municipal court judge rather than having elected, and they're going to outsource the court services. Do you approve of those?
Roswell has always had an elected, Roswell has always had an elected judge. And the move from elect to appoint has been extremely controversial. And I've heard from a lot of residents, they have strong feelings on both sides. I feel like we need to stop and think about the ramifications of what a change is going to mean. When we're deciding whether a judge should be appointed or elected, we need to look at precedent, and we also need to look at what's best for Roswell. Whom does a judge serve? Does a judge serve the people? Does a judge serve the law? And when you look at an elected judge, I'm concerned that that turns a judge into a politician. And I'm not sure that's what a judge wants to be, and I'm not sure that's a comfortable role for judges. But at the same time, if we move to an appointed system, then that does set us up for cronyism, which is a concern among a number of residents. And so I think we need to talk about it more. I think we need to figure out more what's best for Roswell before we move forward.
Thank you. Nancy, we're spending a lot of money to modernize our water system that serves just a quarter of the people. Do we really need to be in the water business?
You know what's coming. Our water system, well, it's more than just our being in the water business on the plant level. It's about having a permit to withdraw from Big Creek, which is not something that would be available again were we to give that up. It's about ceding control to Fulton County at every level where we have proven experience that that is not a good model. And it's about our staff, while they are tasked with providing water to those residents, they are also very helpful in all of our citizens' dealings with Fulton County, which has been hugely helpful. I don't know how much time you spend dealing with Fulton County, but any help you can get on that front is tremendous. And there have been numerous occasions where people have had some kind of issue with their meter or with their system or with their service, and they can't get anywhere with the county, and our staff steps in. Us being in the water business is, you know, on the simple math, it looks like a small number of people for the amount of water that we do and the costs, but the benefit to the city and the lack of dependence on Fulton County, I think, is important for us. And I think that anytime we can reduce our dependence on Fulton County, that's important.
Thank you. Kendra, Roswell cherishes its historic charm, yet it desperately needs regeneration and regrowth. How do we balance the two?
That's a great question, and it's a question that really lies at the heart of the UDC, I feel, especially the UDC's approach to the historic district. We do need development and redevelopment, and when we talk about the success of Canton Street, I think we need to remember what made Canton Street successful, and that's the small businesses and entrepreneurs in Roswell who made it successful, who came together and who had a vision and executed it. Canton Street is also a great example of adaptive reuse, taking old buildings and giving them new life so that new people can appreciate them and get new uses out of them. Canton Street is also one- and two-story buildings. It's not three-, four-, five-, six-story buildings. So while I am pleased that the UDC and the Groveway have design guidelines, I think we need to look at function as well as form and make sure that whatever development and redevelopment we do is for the betterment of Roswell while maintaining that connection to the past that makes us so special.
Thank you. Nancy, as you know, there's a perception that in Roswell, that east is east and west is west, and the two never quite seem to be one together. What can you do to overcome that perception?
We talk about that a lot. You know, the funny thing is, I think the people on the west side don't know there's an issue. I don't hear that on the west side. You never hear I'm from West Roswell. And you hear I'm from East Roswell, and we set about in our discussions, how do we make this bridge? How do we connect people? Because it is a pretty big highway in between us. And the dynamics are quite different from one side to another. The topography is different, the chance for redevelopment is different, the traffic pattern is different. Certainly what Fulton County has left us with as far as massive apartments is somewhat different. But what we want from Roswell is very similar. And we just went through this exercise with the Roswell Library addition, the addition of the East Roswell Library. You know, we in our wisdom thought, we're not gonna have a tall East Roswell Library because that will be separate, and we don't wanna be separate. And what we discovered is there's a huge pride in East Roswell of being there. And they were pretty offended that we would try to get in front of that and not allow it to be East Roswell. So at which point we said, that's great. If they wanna be, you know, East Roswell, like there's the historic district and there's Midtown and there's East Roswell. So I think we need to not try to lose that identity and meld it in too closely. But as we go forward naming our parks and doing some of those things, I think we need to try to make sure what we do doesn't help add to that. I don't know that as a city we can change people's perception of their side of town, but certainly anything we do, we can avoid making it more of an issue.
Along the same lines, there's always been a yin and yang over whether to have the city council remain at large positions or have districts, so that each district could have its own special person to go to. Would you prefer to see this remain as at large, or would you think districts would be better?
I think that the at large approach suits Roswell better because even as we are over 90,000 people, we still like to think of ourselves as a small town and still want to maintain that sense of community. And one of the most rewarding parts of this process of running for city council has been the opportunity that I've gotten to go to every corner of Roswell and to hear from folks on the east side, folks on the west side, folks in the northwest quadrant who are a stone's throw away from Alpharetta, Milton, Johns Creek. So I feel like a council that can incorporate and understand the different perspectives and views from across Roswell is ultimately going to be more effective.
Thank you very much. It's now time for your 1 minute summations.
Well, I'm really excited to be here. And I'm really excited about the prospect of being part of Roswell's growth into the future. I believe strongly in the principles of community engagement and dialogue, of not hearing the same voices all the time, not getting pats on the back from the same people all the time, but really going into the community, ringing doorbells, and hearing what the real people here have to say. Roswell's got a lot of challenges coming. We're growing very fast. We'll be over 100,000 people by 2015, if not sooner. So we need to be very thoughtful and measured about how we grow. I think there's a prevailing attitude that if you build it, they will come, right? So we're going to build all these new things and redevelop. Well, let's remember the last scene of Field of Dreams, which was a line of cars stretching out into the darkness, trying to get to that baseball field in Iowa because the infrastructure couldn't support all the people who wanted to get there. So we need to be careful.
Thank you very much. Our candidates for post six.
That's just too
much. Thank you all for being here. I hope that you've heard answers that are helpful and that you found it's worth your time. I have a record of the last 4 years to go on and for everyone to see. It's very clear what I've stood for, how important our community is to me. My track record speaks for itself, I believe, and I hope that you will find that you see a better Roswell today than you did 4 years ago. And you see more vitality and more value in your home and more reasons to be excited about being here. And I would appreciate the opportunity to serve one more term on City Council. Thank you.
Candidates up here, please. Yeah, if you're
not
you're definitely a candidate. Well, first of all, ladies and gentlemen, let me say that it has always been my belief that good candidates make good politics. And right now, I think we have an example for expanding the members of the city council, because these are excellent choices. You've got a hard job to do. I want to thank these people for coming forward to serve, to run, and perhaps to suffer the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune should they win. But it takes a lot of chutzpah to stand up in front of people and make these hard decisions. And these people here have done that, and I think we deserve to give them all a round of applause. Congratulations to all of you, and talk to your neighbors, make sure they get involved, because they need to know their support. Thank you all.